What's up, guys? Welcome back to Caveman Mining. On today's video, we are going to jump right to things. We are going to be mining ERGO on the new 6600 RX 6600 XT, and that's the MSI Mech Edition. And I don't see too many videos out there as of today in terms of mining on this card with ERGO, especially in HIVEOS. So we're gonna jump right to it. I'm just gonna show you guys the flight sheets on how we can actually set up ERGO. Okay, we'll go ahead and we'll modify the current flight sheet here. And apologies that HIVEOS has just seemed to be running a little bit slow. So what I'm gonna recommend for this particular card is running the ERGO T-Rex miner. Okay, I did try the nano miner and I did not have a lot of success in terms of hash rate and being able to kind of spool things up. So when you set up your flight sheet, you want to set up ERG, E-R-G, so you can type that in or you can just search for it on the list. Go ahead and set up your ERGO wallet. We're going to use Hero Miners as the pool. And again, I mentioned Team Red Miner is the miner that we're going to use. And that's pretty much notoriously known for AMD cards. Okay. So apply that flight sheet. We're going to go into our worker here. And I'm going to open up Hive Shell just so you guys can take a look. And we're going to just run some stock settings here. No overclocks yet. And then we will do a comparison to see can we increase this hash rate up higher in terms of from where it's at stock. So you could be able to kind of take a look at that and see where things stand and compare. So we're going to get into Hive Shell. We're going to get into the miner. And you'll see Auto Lycos running here. So the stock clocks we see here is 1350 on the core, 1200 on the megahertz for the SoC MHZ, 1000 on the memory. Okay, and we're running at 61 watts of power. Okay, so getting a couple shares there and 55.92, so not crazy bad in terms of the power level. Okay, so now let's go over to our overclock settings and we are going to just kind of take a profile for the clock. We're gonna go with 955. I'm gonna do the core 950. And the memory voltage, we'll do 640 to try to kind of tone that down a little bit. 1131 on the memory clock. I'm going to run the fan at full bore at 100. And we're going to go with 100 on the power for watts. So with the core voltage kind of undervolting and running the memory down a little bit, that should keep our power levels, you know, somewhat low. And the idea is to really maximize the hash rate, right? Get as much mega hash as we possibly can. So let's take a look here. We'll do another refresh. This may take a second because I know ERGO's network in terms of like reporting hash rate tends to take a little time to spool up, and we can see the hash rate's already starting to increase. The wattage has actually gone down, so that's a good sign. We're gonna get back into Hive Shell and just kind of watch this live here. And I've noticed that when applying some of these overclocks, it kind of bogs down and then it starts to ramp back up with ERGO versus mining with Ethereum, everything stays pretty consistent. But let's see if we can kind of ramp up here on the hash rate. I'm gonna go ahead and do another refresh. Okay, it's still not reporting. Okay, So take a look at that. We've got 62.52 and running at 59 watts. So that's actually pretty good in terms of hash rate. I've heard of some folks getting, you know, 63, 64, and I think, I don't know if there's someone out there, I haven't seen the video, but someone claims they've got 66 mega hash, but I'm not sure what they are running for, like power or for wattage. But in terms of like efficiency, like take a look at this, 62.71. So just, we're getting just shy of 63 mega hash, and we're gonna hopefully hold that 59 watts. Again, that's not to the wall, so that is just software reporting. So I wouldn't say it's super accurate. We would like need a power meter at the wall to really be able to tell what we're running there. And 62.74 mega hash. Okay, so really ramping up in terms of mega hash. Now let's get an idea of what this would be for like a return on investment and profitability for this card, running at this mega hash and running at this power wattage. So we're gonna tab over to what to mine. We got a share accepted there, 62.75. So we'll kind of go with that. We'll go 62.75. Oops. We're gonna do just say 60 watts. We'll leave that 12 cents a kilowatt hour. The cost of this particular card was $559. We'll just say 1% dev fee. And let's take a look here now with the cost of this card and ERGO, you know, ERGO's value. This brings us just under a year in terms of return on investment. So we've got about 11 months, I would say, close to about 11 months return on investment. So in the overall grand scheme of things, not too bad. Now this card, right, they do make a lower MSRP model. I think the lowest one is $379.99, if I can type in here. I'm gonna go ahead and calculate that, and that should be significantly better in terms of return on investment. So that brings to 229 days roughly for getting your money back on this card, which is actually pretty good. So I would say, you know, if you want to mine ERGO on this card, it's definitely up there in terms of cards to algorithms to mine to, you know, get a good return on investment. And I think, you know, definitely look at the following in the trajectory of ERGO, right? August 3rd, which is a month ago from today, was $5.32. And we've more than tripled that. So we're up to $18.69. And this thing has, you know, climbed the wall over $19, $19.25 yesterday. So yeah, I mean, I can only see the value increasing. This is a quite popular network and algorithm and coin to mine. So I know there's quite a lot of people hodling this coin and just mining as much as they can. So I would say, you know, Ethereum is still very profitable. It's a coin to keep. ERGO, Raven coin, Ethereum Classic. So, you know, there's definitely quite a few algorithms in terms of coins to mine, right? So we'll just take a look at just the general consensus of things to look at, right? Ethereum's at the top for this particular card, and then you get like Firo, which that's interesting. Raven coin, you know, Ethereum Classic, $1.60, you know, $1.69 in terms of profit. And then, you know, Ryo, ERGO, Nicehash, you know, algorithms mixed in there as well. So, you know, pretty much anything you're looking at is still profitable, right? So definitely recommend this card. I like it. I really liked doing this on Ethereum as well. the sheer wattage and you know, just the power efficiency is just, this card is just so, you know, calm and quiet with its wattage that makes it worth it for me. So yeah, if I can get my hands on more of these, I will definitely do that. But in terms of going back to you know, ERGO, right, overclocks, I just want you guys to see. So take a look at my settings here. I'm very, very curious. Can anyone squeeze out more mega hash on Hive OS? I really have just been searching through videos to see if anyone has done a Hive OS hash rate test for ERGO, and I can't seem to find anything. So take a look at my clocks. Let me know in Hive, what are your clocks? And I definitely would like to try them to see if I can squeeze out, you know, a higher hash rate and beat the, you know, beat the 6275 to really top off in terms of hash rate. And you could see, you know, this card's like bounce back down to like 50 mega hash, then back up to 62.81. So it's a little kind of jumping all over the place in terms of the hash rate here. And I don't know if that's due to some of the voltage, undervolting and things of that nature, but yeah, we'll keep experimenting with it and we'll see how things go. So yeah, guys, take a look at the card, try it on ERGO, try it on Hive, and let me know, even in Windows, if you guys have really experimented to see what your clocks are. But with that all being said, we will end the video here. The next video, we will give a try on Ravencoin on this card, so we look forward to checking that out. But please, guys, like and subscribe to the video and my channel to keep me going and bringing you guys some awesome content. So I just want to thank you all once again, and I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day. Take care.